When you have a text value with a date inside it, then you need to parse that date so that IntegraMAT understands it and that you can then also use it in the rest of your scenario. So to demonstrate this, I created this example over here. So this module, our start trigger, is going to watch for new rows inside our Google Sheet. This is our Google Sheet over here, and this basically has a list of appointments with a name, an email address, and the appointment date. So this is the appointment date, and based on this appointment date, we want to create a task inside Notion. So I use Notion to plan my day, and inside Notion, I want to create the task that then says appointment date with, and then the person that I have that appointment with, and then the start time should be set to this value over here. But right now, if I click here save and click run once, then you see that we're going to get an error because IntegraMAT does not understand this format. We have to parse it, right? Here it says invalid date in parameter start time. So to do that, what we can do is we can use the parse date function. So the parse date function, you can put in any field basically, but here I'm going to map it to start time. Then you go to this calendar, and then over here we say parse date. Then you get over here, we see the name of the function. And then here in the first one, before the semicolon, we want to map our variable for the appointment date. And then after the semicolon, we want to tell IntegraMAT basically what that format is. So to do that, what you need to look up is the tokens for date and time formatting. I will also link to this in the description below so that you can check it out. I personally just bookmarked this because I need it quite often. But then we need to look for all the things related to that format. So for example, over here, we have the 12th, the 14th, the 2nd, that's what it's starting with. So it's like the day of the month. So then over here, we look for day of the month. All right, day of the month with ordinal. Now then over here, we see that the token for that is DO. So I'm just copying this over here and then I put it in there and then I click a space. And then we look for the second thing. Okay, it's just a word, it's just off. So in this case, we can just type here off. Then we have the month, so that's the full month name. So then over here you see we have the month name. So the token for this is 4 times M in capitals. So it's also really important that you then type it in capitals, otherwise it's going to break. And then the word at, so then we tap at, and then a space, and then we have a time. So here I'm using the 24 hour time. So if you use a 12 hour time, then you obviously have to do it a little bit different, but then you just look up the token for that. So then I look for time. Okay, here we have week, here we have hours, minutes, seconds, and I need the 24 hour time. Now then we look, okay, we have 24 hour time and we have 20 hour time with leading zero. So that if it's like 1 at night, then we have a 0 in front of it. So then we look at our examples over here, and then you see over here that we have a leading 0, for example, at 8 in the morning. So this is 8 a.m. So then we need 2 times H, then do this in there. Then we go here and then we see that we have the colon. So I type the colon and then we have the minute. So then we go here to minutes. So here minutes with leading 0. So that's 2 times M. 2 times M, all right. Then I remove the space in here. Here I also tap include time. I click now, okay. I click save, I click run once. And then right now you see we're going to get a new row. And then this was a success because this time it properly mapped the start time of our task. So here, due date, you can see now that this is properly converted. So now that we parsed it, IntegraMAT also understands it, and then you can also do all kinds of things with it. So if you want, you can, for example, also add days to it, you can subtract days, you can add months to it, you can format it to another day. So all kinds of cool things. If you want to learn more about that, then just check out this tutorial over here. And if you have any questions about this, just then let me know in the comments below.